today we're working on a Hyster model H155XL. Load capacity for this bad boy is about 10,000 pounds. And when we have max load capacity, we can only go up to about 48 inches. But the total weight for this Hyster is about 21,360 pounds. So currently today, before we even get into further, go any further in this video, we have a couple issues today. So as you can see already, the chain is already off. So currently the seals are under repair on the hydraulics, and we need to reconnect the chain. It's going to be happening later on this week. Another issue that we had earlier today was that the battery housing that we had, both batteries failed. So luckily we had a really high speed go-getter on our team, and he actually he fixed everything. We had a bad housing, we had bad connections, we had to recrimp the wires as well as crimp new wires. Plus both of the batteries that we had in there was both pushing out about 5 volts. So currently our battery is now running parallel and they're about 12.7. So when we're doing the visual inspection, we gotta check the surroundings and everything. We gotta make sure there's no cracks, no damages, no leaks. So obviously we gotta do a walk around and everything, make sure there's no cracks or damages on any of the mechanics and everything like that. We gotta make sure none of the hoses are loose, no loose fittings, nothing like that. No leaks or anything like that. And we gotta make sure that all these chains are properly greased. So now we're going to currently go over to the left side of the forklift over here. So one thing we got to check, we got to make sure we got to check the oil. So as you can see, we're pretty much level on that. And also when we're checking the, while we're on the left side of the engine, we might as well check the belts and everything like that, make sure that they're gripping well. All right, so I'm gonna push over to the right side now. One major thing to check on the right side is we gotta make sure we gotta check the air filter over here. So I've already disconnected the air filter for the most part, so I'm just gonna pull it out and show you guys how this one is currently looking. So as you can see, it's pretty dirty, but at the end of the day, it's still gonna work. But then a couple of I would say to give it about a month, we gotta change the air filter out though. So, since we did a visual inspection of the engine and everything on the outside, now we can check the check the lights and everything. So I'm gonna start the vehicle up for the most part, turn the lights on. And as you can see right now, one of our backlights actually works. The other one has failed, bad circuit, or we gotta change up the bulb. And currently up here, both our lights work. So from here on, we're gonna do a functions check. And as I said earlier, we cannot check the hydraulics, we cannot lift the fork, or we can't do any of that because currently it's under repair. But I will turn the vehicle over so you can see that the vehicle is capable of turning. We just changed the battery. So one major point that OSHA actually is a stickler about: make sure that the belt pulls all the way out and actually clip. And here on, you gotta make sure the vehicle is in neutral. Then, it's not cutting over. So now that it doesn't turn over, we gotta actually do another function. We're gonna actually do a visual inspection on our end. But as of right now, that's about all for the video.